reunited and it feels so good. So, today we are going to talk about the do's and don'ts of... Oh, shit. So I'm going to take it from today. Okay. Hey fellow beauty finders, this is Mathias Allen. Thank you so much for clicking on my newest video. So welcome back to Monday Makeup Chat. For those of you guys who are loyal subscribers, you know that every single week I like to bring you another point of view. I always bring pro makeup and hairstylists to my channel, and today I have Lavonne Beauty all the way from New York.
Hi!
Lavonne, thanks for coming.
Thanks for having me, Mathias. So happy to be here.
We've had such a good day already.
Yes, we have. We've had lots and lots of fun and lots of reminiscing.
Today, we're going to talk about the do's and don'ts
of working with African-American skin.
Now, for those of you guys who have watched me for months or years on YouTube, you know that I love working with African-American skin tones, and I have many tutorials about how to do makeup for black skin. Today, I got to do Lavonne's makeup, and there are videos coming, so you've got to subscribe. But I want to ask Lavonne what she thinks are the do's and don'ts of working with black skin.
Oh, well, there's many. Do try it. Don't do it if you don't know how to do it.
That's good point. Important. And you're talking to the makeup artists out there who want to get into the industry, who want to start working with celebrities or models or even their friends. And even if you're a Caucasian girl from the Midwest, you know, if you want to start working in big cities like New York or LA or Miami, you got to learn how to do black skin, right?
You have to have the correct products in your kit. There's no excuse not to have the correct products in your kit.
Okay. All right. So what are some of the correct products that you feel are essentials? Without spending like, you know, $1,000 on a whole African-American maybe complexion kit.
Absolutely.
What are some of your favorite things?
My favorite foundation is AG Crimson.
Okay.
My favorite powders, I love the MAC Mineralized Skin Finishes, the pressed powders. I also love Ben Nye powders, the loose ones. And for concealers, I like NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. And I like Makeup Forever Concealers. Those are probably my go-tos. Here's the thing I found with AJ's foundation. A little goes a long way. That's why when you look at the container, it's not this deep. It's maybe that deep. Mm. You don't need a lot. The coverage is really flawless, but you have to use it sparingly. And I personally apply it with a beauty blender sponge. Or the Sigma Kabuki brushes. Mm. I like those too.
Now, speaking of foundation that is very pigmented that you don't want to use a lot of, my favorite foundation for African American skin tone, I actually have it right here. And the reason I have it right here is because I used it on Lavonne today. It's the Kevin Aucoin Sensual Skin Enhancer.
Lovely.
If you want to be knowledgeable about this product, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel because there is a demo coming up where I'm going to show you exactly how to color match this foundation on African American skin and how to blend it and apply it. And it really just became the most flawless foundation
ever. First time I've ever used it on myself. I've used it on other people just because somebody had it in a kit and I tried it out and I loved it, but never have I used it on myself until Mathias put it on me today. Slay.
And you know that secret really is that priming serum that I use first, which if you guys want to know what it is, you've got to subscribe to my YouTube channel and or check down below for the description to that video, because really you have to make the skin really glide before you put it on, because otherwise it doesn't move, so you have to be careful. So what are some other like do's and don'ts when you're working with African American skin?
I think it's also really important that you highlight and contour. Black women have hyperpigmentation, they have discoloration sometimes, they're lighter in some areas, darker in others. So you have to know how to highlight and contour without it looking cakey. No cake face. You can highlight and contour on an African American woman and it look flawless and it look even, so that the makeup looks like it melts into the skin where there's no line of demarcation. You can't tell there's a bunch of makeup on there.
I totally agree. Another thing that I think is important for people to know when they're doing African American skin tones is that a lot of times they have a dark circle around the eye, and it's usually hereditary.
Yes. When you have like that dark circle under the eye, you have to color correct. One thing you used today, which I really loved, was the Anastasia Contour Kit, and use what color was it? The coral?
This was the coral, which is this one right here in the
all
center.
All around the eye, just totally canceled out any dark circles. It was a great color corrector.
Oh my God, this kit was amazing on Lavonne's skin today. I'm gonna show you in that video that I was just talking about that how this coral color is a color corrector for around the eyes. And then I did a little bit of spot treatment on any kind of hyperpigmentation.
I have some acne scarring on my skin, so that was really good. It covered that as well too, without looking cakey.
Yeah, no, not at all. Like, she's but like, ooh, let me see.
We've been fighting over this mirror
yes, honey,
since
let's see.
It looks really good. Amazing.
How do you feel about powder? Because one of my pet peeves is when makeup artists who is not completely as experienced with different color powders, they think that a translucent powder, which looks white or light pink or pinky beige,
don't get me started
on all people.
It translucent, won't. Like saying, like when you go to buy pantyhose and you pick up the nude pair, they only look nude on one skin tone, Caucasian skin tone.
Right?
However, if you take a powder that is pigmented, that is our translucent. It's just, what are you going to call it? African American translucent?
Right? Right?
This is black translucent.
Yes.
Translucent blackness.
Black lucent.
Black lucent.
I love this powder. I'm obsessed with the Ben Nye Topaz powder, you guys. This little powder is incredible.
It's
I don't even know. It's black lucent on all of my black friends and clients. Yeah, this is gorgeous. It's kind of like a cross between a tangerine and a mustard. And it's really flawless. Mm-hmm. I baked her face. I'm going to show you in a video coming up how to bake. I also think that it's really important to apply a heavier powder or a lot of loose powder on African American skin tone, because I find that African American skin tones
are a little bit more oily.
Are a lot more oilier. Mm-hmm. And that's why you don't crack after 70, honey, because you got so much oil in your skin. I'm
guess
jealous.
How old I am. Guess how old I am. Guess how old I am.
Girl, she's
guess
80. Girl, I don't
guess
need to
how
guess.
Old
she's
I am.
80. I know.
4-0. 40, baby.
Mm-hmm.
Good black don't crack, honey. We all know.
Mm-mm. It's good, honey. It is good.
I look forever 21, but I'll be 41. Mm. So, hey.
So, you guys, I hope you guys took notes. If you want any discount codes to any of the products I talked about or Lavonne talked about, check down below in my description box. And before you guys go, I want you guys to follow Lavonne Beauty on all social media, because she is a pro makeup artist. Hello, she's from the East Side. She's from New York.
No. I'm from the West Side.
I know, that's true. She is
from
the
West
Side.
That's born and raised, straight out of Santa Ana.
I know. That's true. We did know each other in the OC. We go back way, way long. But you've been in New York for years. And tell me, like, what have you been working on?
New York has been great. I do a lot of e-commerce. I do a lot of work with Hearst, with a lot of the digital online content for Elle, for Marie Claire, for Good Housekeeping, for Redbook. I do a lot of beauty tutorials, which I just had something come out yesterday on how to do cat eyes. So you got to check that out on goodhousekeeping.com. And I also work with a lot of private clients, and I really enjoy doing Fashion Week every season.
You sure do. I mean, she's been to London, she's been to Paris, she's done Fashion Week in New York. So definitely follow her on all social media. Thanks you guys for watching, and please subscribe, because Lavonne is coming back, honey. We got lots more advice for you, so stay tuned.
Bye, everybody. Ta-ta.